Glory to Jesus Christ. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Hello, brothers. Hello, sisters in Christ. I hope that you all are well in the Lord. It's so good to see you guys, and I'm always honored to be your sister in Christ. And I thank you for taking time out of your day to come and hang out with me and see what the Lord is saying. People of God, this is going to be a prophetic word. This is another word that initially I did not think that I needed to share it. But later, Holy Spirit told me, yes, someone needs to hear it. The reason is because there's a timing mechanism attached to this word, as well as an alignment. God wants you to stay in alignment with His will in this particular time. Okay, this block of time, there's an alignment, okay, that God wants us to stay in. So before I get into the word for today, let's say a quick prayer. Will you pray with me? Dear Heavenly Father, dear Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we love you so much. We come humbly before you, Lord God. We come to you with an open heart and an open mind. We want to receive whatever it is that you have for us in this hour, Father God. Jesus, not my will, but yours. And I ask, Lord God, that you will place my words, my way of thinking, my thoughts, whatever it is that is not of you, with your Holy Spirit, so I can speak directly to your children. That comes from the throne. It comes from you. Father God, we thank you for covering this broadcast. We thank you for giving us the opportunity to fellowship. And we pray, Lord God, that you will dwell within our presence as we are here to hear what it is that you're saying, in Jesus' holy name. So, people of God, there was an occurrence that happened in my life just not too long ago. And this person, I'm not going to say any names, but this person came to me and she said, congratulations, Shanika. Congratulations on getting that particular thing, is what she was talking about. And I looked at her and I immediately knew that she was being untruthful about what she was saying, because what she was referring to could only be known by me and not anybody else. She proceeded to say that she heard from someone over the phone about the situation, and it was not only me that had received this particular thing, but it was also someone else that was connected to me that she had heard that received this particular thing. But again, I knew that what she was saying was untruthful, because there was no way that she would be able to receive the information before I would, if that makes sense, okay? And so as I was listening to her, thank you, Jesus, I just give God all the glory for the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit allowed for me to think quickly. The Holy Spirit allowed for me to respond in a way that was pleasing to God. And so I just simply responded to her by saying, well, thank you. Thank you for that information. And I left it just like that. So guys, with that being said, the Lord began to speak to me after she left my presence. I thought about it and I said, God, now why did this person come to me with this lie? It was a lie. Why would this person come to me with an untruth story that she say she heard, when it couldn't have happened because I was never in a position to be able to receive what she was saying that I was going to receive? Hallelujah. And that's when the Holy Spirit began to speak to me. And the Holy Spirit began to say, Shanika, beloved, they trying to figure you out. They trying to figure it out. But God does not want you to reveal the plans that you and He have been working together on until the right time, until the appointed time. So people of God, the prophetic word is this. They are trying to figure you out. They're trying to figure out what you're doing. They're trying to figure the situation out. They're trying to figure out how or when or why. But God says He wants you to keep your mouth closed until He tells you to release it. The Lord is saying that in this particular group of people, these are not the same people that He's referring to in the last video that I did. I did a video that talked about how God was going to use your enemies as your footstool. And those enemies were people that have slandered you in some way. They have gossiped about you in some way. They have lied on you in some way. They've done something negatively, and those people may or may not have apologized to you. There is a group of people that God is going to use to elevate you. However, for this group, and I need you guys to hear this, for this particular group of people, the Lord is not going to use these people, because these particular people right here have taken extra steps. They have taken extra measures to be deceitful. Not only have they gossiped about you, have they lied on you, have they slandered you, have they been envious or jealous of you, I see in the spirit, God is showing me sorcery. God is showing me witchcraft. God is showing me prayers, altar prayers, things that are very wicked. These people have went as far as consulting mediums, and or they've went as far as getting directions offline to see how they could sabotage you, how they could take you out of here. Hallelujah. They have taken some evil measures that you are not fully aware. So God is saying that this is a group of people that he will not use. He will not use these people, but instead he wants you to stay silent. He wants you to keep what is happening in your life to yourself. God is saying that there is a person that has tried to go behind you by going to a family member of yours and asking questions. They tried to go to a friend of yours and ask questions. They tried to go to a coworker that you are close to and ask questions. They've tried to do all they can to go around you to find out what you're doing. They've been watching you. They've been watching or listening to the conversations that you've been having with people in their presence. They have been following you in some way. And this is in addition to the witchcraft and the negative things that they've been doing behind the scenes, okay? God is saying that these particular people are trying to figure you out. And the whole purpose of them doing it is so they can take what the Lord has given you, so they can take what you've worked hard for, so they can take what is only for you for themselves. This person or these people want to be like you. This person or these people want what you have. They want your spouse. They want your children. They want your job. They want your ministry. Hallelujah. They want your way. They want your words. They want your stance. They want your personality. They want the respect that you get from people. Hallelujah. They want the friends that you have. They want the circle. They want the blessings. They want the anointing. Hallelujah. And God is saying that they will not get it. They will not get it. God is saying that he has blocked that. Again, the plot against you will fail. It will continue to fail. But the enemy is going to try now to come to your face. God is saying to pay attention. This is how you're going to know the difference between the people that he's going to use to help you that have slandered you and the people that have slandered you and did additional things, the witchcraft and the following and the monitoring. This is the difference between the two. God is saying that when this person comes to you, or when these people come to you, hallelujah, this is for somebody. I don't know who you are. When this, if they haven't already done it, when they come to you, you're going to know, because they're going to ask you a question, Jesus. They're going to ask you a question to which there is no way of them knowing. They're going to phrase something to you that there is no way of them knowing. The goal of the question, the goal of the phrase, is for you to open up about what you're doing. Hallelujah. They're going to try to get you to open up about what you're doing. They're going to try to get you to respond so you can tell the story of what's happening in your life. The whole goal is for them to see what God is doing in your life, so they can try to plot, so they can try to pray, so they can try to set up the altars and the sorcery against you. But God is saying that he wants you to be silent, because they are trying to figure you out. They are trying to figure out what you're doing. And the reason why is because you're a person where you don't share your personal business with everybody. You're not a person that goes around and tell everybody what you're doing. And because everybody else around you is doing it and you're not, you're a target. It puts them into a state of unrest because they're trying to figure out what's going on in your life. They're trying to figure out how you're glowing, how you are progressing, how you are where you are today. They want that from you. And so they're trying to do all that they can to get that information out of you. So God is saying, child of God, that when they come to you, you're going to know because there's going to be a phrase or there's going to be a question that's going to indicate that they don't really know, or it may indicate that they think that they know, but it's going to require for you to have to explain where you are in your life right now. Jesus, it's going to be said to try to provoke you to give them the details, to give them the plan, to give them the steps, to give them the things that you and God have been working on behind the scenes. It's going to try to provoke you to speak out what the Lord is blessing you with in this hour. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So God is saying, keep it to yourself. Do not reveal anything to anyone in this time frame until he tells you to do it. All right. They are trying to figure you out. And this is a set of people. This is a set of enemies that God is not going to use to assist you. And they're going to come to you with a question or a phrase that is going to provoke an explanation. It's going to provoke your plan, your strategy on how you're moving forward. Jesus. Okay, guys. So test the spirit. Remember, I have a video in the description box that will give you some tips on how to test the spirit. You make sure that with every question, every phrase that comes to you from a person that you know is not necessarily for you, in a sense, you have a history of, you know, just negativity per se. Choose your words wisely. Choose how you respond. Allow the Holy Spirit to direct you on how to respond. And then when they leave your presence, you pray about it and you pay attention to what they were saying to you. Pay attention to the words that were coming out of their mouth. Guys, God wants you to be successful in this moment in time, and he will not allow not one person to try to sabotage it. Okay, guys? So I love you. I want you to be blessed. Remember, we are here on purpose to glorify God in Jesus' holy name. I love you guys. And if it's the Lord's will, I'll see you sometime next week. Okay? Bye.